I'm all about speed and accuracy, and so that's one reason why I made the 9-patch ruler and the 4-patch ruler. And also, we started putting different things in the center of our options, and we need those units to be as perfect as possible. Now, the problem with making 4 patches and 9 patches is that you sew all of these long strips together. And even if you do a great job with your cutting and a great job with your sewing, when you go to press, they start moving around on you. The other thing is that when we sew long strips together, we just feel like that we've got an open territory to just fly that sewing machine just as quick as we can, and we don't always keep our 1/4 inch seam allowance a good scant measurement the way that it should be. So the 4-patch ruler and the 9-patch ruler help you save time by knowing right exactly when you make that cross cut on your piece of fabric if this is a good patch unit to use. If it's a good one, I will continue to make my 9 patches or 4 patches. And if it isn't, then I don't want to waste any more time on it. Time is the most important thing that we have, and so many times we start sewing these pieces together, then we go to press them and open them up, and we realize that our seams don't match and they don't have the length and the width that they should. So the 9-patch ruler and the 4-patch ruler help you save time by knowing earlier in the process if this is a good unit or not. Now, when I have my 3 strips sewn together to use the 9-patch ruler, whatever the width is of my strip, that's the measurement I find right here on this first row of numbers. My unit should fit inside the appropriate rectangle. My heavy grid line should work right here on this top seam, and all of these stair step lines, one of those should fit on the bottom seam. The ruler's designed so it'll work for any width of fabric and for any size of 9 patches that you want to make. So here I have a stair step line on my bottom seam, I have my heavy grid line on the top, and my fabric piece fits inside that rectangle unit. So right now when I make the cut, I know this is a good piece, and I want to continue to invest the most precious thing I have, and that's my time, in this unit. As I keep cutting through here, some of these will be good and some will be bad. I want to take the good ones and continue making those for my 9-patch units. But if I wanted to use these in a 9-patch, I would want to make sure that these seams match up perfectly so that I can get a nice even seam and that my length is exactly what it should be. If it matches up with the ruler, then I know I will have a good 9-patch unit. Now this block here is a great example of needing a nice 9-patch unit. The option 10s are these triangle units that are on the outside edge. And if this 9-patch unit in the center is too big or too small, then I'm not going to get the right amounts off of the edges here of my option 10 unit when I sew those to my 9-patch. The 9-patch ruler really will help you perfect a very simple, basic, beautiful block, the 9-patch. Now the next one I want to demonstrate for you is the 4-patch unit, and it works basically the same way that the 9-patch unit works. And you have your 2 strips sewn together, and you have your 4-patch ruler. And once again, the heavy grid line goes on your seam, and you just slide it around until the fabric fits inside the rectangle unit. If it matches here and it matches inside here, then I know this is a good unit, and once again, I will continue to invest my time in this unit. In the quilt Blaze, which is in the Diamonds book, we use double 4-patch units like you see here to make a 16-patch that goes inside the quilt, and the units are very, very small. Using the 4-patch tool, it's easy to get multiple units together and they all work out to be the same size. Of course, when I get ready to sew these together, I want my seams to nestle together just like that, and the length here should fit and the length here should fit. And when I use my new 9-patch and 4-patch tool, I get perfect 4 patches that I can put in the center of my options, or I can use them in other locations in the quilt. The next quilt here I want to show you is actually our Block of the Month program for the Sisters of the Square and a Square Society. I used double 4 patches to make the border, and I was just amazed at how perfect all the points came out and how the length of the border was exactly the length I needed it to be to fit on the edges of the quilt. You will just simply be amazed how easy the 4-patch tool and the 9-patch tool are to use and how it can really perfect your patchwork and other areas of your quilting.